guys, this is Stephanie Pettis in the Rolling Studio, and I'm coming at you today for a VR for our beloved Angie C, Itty Bitty Crafts, also a Tiny House Co. You can check her out on YouTube, Facebook, and she is an artist that does little bitty houses, and she loves miniatures, and everything about her is itty bitty. When it comes to her her work, she loves to do miniatures and loves the challenge of it and loves to see what people come up with. So I want to go ahead and do a VR for her. So Angie, if you're watching and you don't want to see what you're getting, please turn away now. Otherwise, let's get started. Okay, I decided to go, of course, out of the box because that's me. I have a group called Out of the Box Creations because I like to think outside of the box, always have. It's just my style. And when she said she was doing her 2-year challenge on YouTube, this is her 2-year celebration for YouTube, then I decided she loves miniatures and might as well go ahead and challenge myself and see what I can come up with. So the first thing that I did, well, I worked on a few things just to see if I could get going on it, and I'm gonna tell you, it was a lot of fun, but quite a few late nights, I'm just saying. And that was definitely a challenge for me. I do bigger things and I like to do small things too, but I kind of did some micro mini stuff, so we'll see. Maybe it's not micro enough, but it's definitely mini for me. And I decided to put it all in a box that would commemorate her as well. So this is my faux brush metal box. So it's kind of a vintage-y brush metal look, and it's just a simple box made with foil. And I did some aging on it, so I hope you like it. This is the itty bitty faux brush metal box. And I am not trying to push the lid all the way down because, well, some things got a little tall in there. And you'll see what I mean. But I put her name, it's actually Itty Bitty Crafts, but Itty Bitty is what she goes by on YouTube, and that's Angie C. And I kind of did a little brush metal. I took a die cut and I did some hot gluing around it. Well, not around the, I just kind of did a rendering of what the die cut was, and I put it on the box, and then I did this whole brush metal, and I did it in a rose gold color, pink and rose gold and a little black. I did use black as well and I wiped it off, but then I turned around and did a pink wash over it, dry brush, and then I laid it with some rose gold from my the alchemy waxes, the Prima waxes, the Finnebear. And those waxes are absolutely my favorite. So I know you might not be able to get the full essence with the glare, but this actually has a rose gold tone on the lid. So let me get started and show you what's in the little bitty box. Okay. Because I like to go out of the box, I thought it would be really cute to do a semi rendering of Angie's craft table might be. I know she has a mat and we always just see the mat, and I did it by memory because I haven't looked at her mat in a while. I forgot, so I just kind of did it, and it's a little off, but I have some silk material, some lace, and some trim, and a cameo, and some little other trim, and she likes to do the little felt gnomes. So, and forgive my fingers, they're full of glue and paint and all that kind of stuff. She likes to do those felt gnomes, so I did a little needle and wool there or whatever that they use, the felt. And I just kind of stuck that on the table there. But I have this right here because I lightly tacked them down just because I thought it was cute. But I actually used a foam for this table. And I know you can see it, but I initially glued the little mat on here. And you'll see what I'm talking about in a minute. But I took it back off because I wanted it to stay in the box and be safe. So I put it underneath this table that I made. So, first of all, on her table, let me just zoom in here. Okay, like I said, first off on her table, I kind of imagined what, off camera, whatever she might be working on. And I thought, well, maybe she's working on some fabric paper. So I made a little glass mat out of some acetate. And I actually did some fabric paper. So this is actual fabric paper on this little foam mat. And I made a little paintbrush like if she was busy decoupaging it. So there's that. On one of my lives, I finally got in some UV resin and I created a paperweight and it was just for her. So here is the little paperweight and I cut out these little colorful papers again. I'm probably going to have to redo these because I glued it down initially. I'll make fresh papers. Anyway, so they got a little gluey. I'll fix that. But a little paperweight, I just thought it was too freaking cute. The little paperweight definitely has some elements inside of it because I wanted to try that. And again, we did that on a live that I had, on the fly live. And go ahead and remove this paper and the fabric paper mat. And this is the little foam table. I used some beads and created the legs. And just gave it a little rough wood finish look. I didn't shine it up, but it's just meant to hold her stuff. So while her table is there, I'll go ahead and pull out one of the first things I started with. And I may be remaking this in a more shabby tone. This was just my first try and I was running out of time. And I wanted to get this out when I got home. So she may be getting this. I don't know. This is my little mini faux tumbler. It is an all-out crystallized. I say crystallized. I did it at a tumbler just like you would a regular tumbler. And I put some coffee in it so that she could have her skanky cup of Joe, as we call it. And there's an old funny joke about that. So she may want to glue that down on her desk. I kind of left them where she can put things where she wants. I did pick up this little lamp. I thought it was cute. And it works. It's unfortunately, it's not real strong. But the light does come on. And it's got its own little base. So she can put that on her table if she wants to. Or near her table. I gave her a few miniature rhinestones and beads so that she could lay them out on her table if she wanted to. Some baby doilies and some lace if she wanted to. And then this one, this is the prize, really. I'm super proud of this. And it definitely was a challenge. But here is her little craft mat. So stinking cute. That's a little string right there. I've got a little doily with some beads on it. Like she's busy working. I've got a couple of tags. One says love, one says life or live. Because she likes to write that on her tags. Love, laugh, live, stuff like that. And then we have a miniature little feather inkwell that I created. And there's an 1800s book. Let me just lift this up and get that. There's a little 1800s book on her craft mat. And I took the liberty of putting some little silver dots on the corners, like it had the little brads there. Book corners. I did a little paint jar. I've got glue all over me. I did a little paint jar with paint brushes and pens and things like that in there. And then I did a little faux scroll paper, just because she likes vintage, and a little rendering of a key that I made a while back. It's supposed to be a key, but I made that a while back, and I just thought it would be cute to include that. I do have some keys at home I will be putting on here as well. And here's a tiny little house. This little sucker, I mean, if it's as big as my finger, my pinky nail. I mean, that's how big it is. That's it. That's about the size of it. It's got the tree, the bush, the concrete walkway, the grassy knoll. On the back, it's got a cliff, a rocky little cliff. If you can see that. And it's surrounded by water and the waves, you know, hitting. So I just thought it was super cute. And I put it on a wood toggle bead that I recently received from Nancy Light. That I haven't even gotten to that with my Happy Mail video that will be in another part. But that toggle, wood toggle bead was perfect. And I was like, oh my gosh, I'm going to set my tiny little house on top of that wooden toggle. So there it is. I hope she likes it. I hope you like it. If you are watching this, Angie, it was a lot of fun. It was a lot of work, but I had a lot of fun doing it. Now, aside from that, this is the bottom of my box so that you can see the little lady in here. And I actually just took some Sharpies and kind of created a little background there for her, just to give it some shadow and essence. I lined the box with silk and trim. And this is part of the faux finish of the rest of the box. It's a little rough, but I kind of think it gives it character. So, I hope she likes it. Hope you like it, Angie, if you did watch it. And then there's one more little prize, and it's right here. And I will let that be separate. I won't even open this. But you'll have to go watch her VR, or her entry, to see what I made here. And I'm just gonna say, it's the first time I've ever made one. I've never made one, and the first one was a mini. Just so that you know, you'll have to go look at Itty Bitty Crafts when she does that. But check out this tumbler. Is that not cute? It fell a couple of times since then, and the polish got messed up, so I'm pretty sure I will be making her a new one. But this was the cutest thing. This is a tumbler. You know what you drink out of. And this is my... and I'm going to be coming out with a video on a tumbler that I've made. It's very unique. And just be looking out for that video, because it's a Halloween treat. And it's going to be super cool. I'm almost finished with it. But... to you, Angie, your skanky cup of Joe. Shelly reminded me to say that, by the way. Oh, and there it goes. And that's why I have to make a new one. It had fresh polish on it, and I just dropped it. So, one more tumbler to make, and I'm probably going to do it in a more shabby chic style, if I can get to it before I get home and get it done. So, I can get it in the mail, and she can have this. So... there you go. Thanks for the challenge, Angie. Congratulations on your 2-year. And I hope you like what I created for you. And this is all you. This is all you. So I hope you enjoy it. I hope you like it. Happy crafting. See you next time. Bye. And that's why I don't want to put that on the top. Let me just take that off. We'll stick it back here in the safe zone. I love that paper.